my brother in the front, who asked, well, can you give us like a routine, a daily routine in talab al-ilm, like in benefiting, in learning? What should we do on a daily basis?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا شك أن الوقت يختلف من شخص إلى آخر.
No doubt that time differs from one person to another person.
ولكن الأمر المهم جدا هو ألا تنقطع عن العلم ولو قليلا.
But what is very important is that you should not discontinue learning even if it's for a short period. Don't discontinue learning.
فقليل مستمر ودائم خير من كثير يتقطع.
For little that you gain that is continuous is better than that which is done for a while and then it's disconnected.
فلا بد من تخصيص وقت لك في اليوم للقراءة أو سماع أشرطة العلماء.
So you must specify some time during the day for reading and for listening to the speech of the scholars.
والآن ولله الحمد العلماء موجودون معك حيثما انتقلت في هاتفك. ومن أردت من العلماء تسمع لهم.
And now, alhamdulillah, you can, يعني the scholars are with you because you are with your phone. You can, wherever you go, you can listen to the speech of the scholars.
ولا بد أن تركز على مبادئ العلوم في الأول صغارها ثم كبارها.
And you must actually pay attention to learning the foundations of the knowledge based. Books. You start with the small, يعني the most important, and then in stages you learn.
من الأشياء المهمة في الدورات أيها الكرام أن الدورة هي كالمفتاح لك في طلب العلم.
So what is important in conferences like these conferences is that it's like a key for you to يعني to leap forward or to step forward in your path of knowledge.
من أكثر الأخطاء وأكبرها ألا تنشغل بالعلم إلا في الدورات ثم تنقطع لا فائدة.
So one of the biggest mistakes that occurs is that you find people they come in large multitudes and they concentrate in coming to conferences but they thereafter discontinue their learning.
حتى في الدروس الأسبوعية مع الدعاة ومع المشايخ بعض الإخوة ما يعرف الكتاب إلا في الدرس بل بعضهم يترك الكتاب في المسجد. هذا طلب علم قاصر. يجب عليك أن بعد الدرس تراجع تقرأ تنظر في كلام أهل العلم شروح تتوسع هكذا يثبت العلم.
Even in the classes that the callers called have and set the teachers when they teach you, it is not correct that one leaves his book, for example, in the masjid and he only opens his book when he comes to the dars. Rather, take your book home, open it before, during, after, so you benefit from what you are learning.